I'm another lead guitarist and backing vocalist. Male as well, yeah. He, him. There's Keith out there, actually. What's the crack? So jolly.
Atomic. Yeah, no, seriously. No, I won't. No. No, but like Atomic and Kids in America, I'm sitting there like buying a shoe. Thank you!
Oh, yeah, Losing Jer. Losing Jer in Cork.
It's showtime, guys. Let's rock and roll! Yo, what's crack, everyone? Welcome back to the Arcane Pain. We are here in beautiful Limerick in Dolan's Pub to watch a very special group, and they're all here right behind me. They are the Grand Theft Audio group themselves, and they are a tribute band to GTA Vice City, the best GTA, a lot of people's opinions. So we've got to do a little bit of an interview here. We're going to ask them a few questions and get the goss. Get the background, guys. So, guys, how are we? Are we all good?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I'd like to hear.
Hey, my name is Aileen, and I'm the female lead vocalist of GTA.
Hello, my name is Paul. I'm a lead guitarist, backing vocalist, and cowbell player apparently now today.
My name is Brendan. I'm the bass player, and that's it.
My name is Jer, and I am the male singer of the band.
My name is Steven, and I am another lead guitarist and backing vocalist.
Male as well,
yeah. He, him.
My name's Richard, I play saxophone, and I do vocals.
My name is G, and I play keys, synths, and balloon guitar.
I'm Steven, I'm the drummer, one of the chauffeurs, and general caretaker of the band, yes.
Yeah, hey, how's it going? Kozak here, and I am the organizer of Grand Theft Audio, and I also play a bit of keys, congas, bongos, and the chimes, of course, and a little bit of vocals. We have Keith now, the 10th member. We didn't have him in the first gig, but we realized pretty quickly that we needed somebody else on the team. There's Keith, though, there, actually. What's the crack? So jolly.
We are Grand Theft Audio. We're here to be together with you here tonight to celebrate.
Really happy to be here. Thanks so much, guys, for giving us the occasion to have a chat. Really excited to be here in Limerick, in Dolans, to play one of our last gig for the summer, really. So super excited. But you can find us online on Grand Theft Audio Live on Instagram. Best place to find us, guys, for all the most up-to-date content. So we'd love to see you there and join our community. And we love all our fans. It's great to see you all at the gigs. So do stay tuned. Stay tuned to all of our upcoming gigs as well. So, cheers for having us. Thanks.
Shut up, sit down, relax. I'll tell you what we're going to do.
It started back in 2018, I think the idea came to me. But way before, and that was to create the band, but way before that, of course, I was playing Vice City as a young teenager, probably too young for the game, I'm sure, like most other people, and was just absolutely amazed by the game itself. The location, the vibe of Miami, of course, really resonated with me. But most importantly, the soundtrack was just absolutely fantastic. So I fell in love with the music. And years and years later, of course, then after playing in other projects, this idea came to me. And the company that I run is called Damaris Entertainment, and we focus on unique events. So this was something that, you know, I felt was a great idea. And naturally, at the start, you don't know if it's a great idea until you execute it. So it took us a while to kind of get it off onto the road. And obviously, COVID hit us, and that slowed things down. But met these wonderful people here, sitting in front of you more so today. And really great team. We couldn't have done it with any other team as well, I have to say. So a lot of work is put into the project. But that's kind of how it sort of started. It was just a random thing that popped into my head, I suppose. But the love for Vice City was there for so many years. So that must have sprung, obviously, from that. So that's, I think, the answer to the question, perhaps.
You better be kidding me, Tommy. Tell me you still got the money.
No, Sonny. I don't have the money.
That was my money, Tommy!
That is definitely one of them. But I did play San Andreas as well and spent a lot of my days playing that game. Definitely, you know, gameplay-wise, fantastic game. Also great soundtrack. But there was something special about Vice City that I personally felt to that game. So I don't know if it was because it was so innovative of its time. It was something, a huge expansion on Grand Theft Auto 3, especially with the music. Because in 3, there wasn't as many recognizable tunes. So Vice City brought in that kind of commercial music appeal. And also just the vibe of it, everything. So for me, like that Miami style, it was just really cool. I love the movie Scarface as well. So there was a lot of sort of connection between those, obviously, with the storyline. But just the tunes are absolutely cracking. What can I say, guys? It's just so much fun. I'm a big fan of 80s music, big fan of 80s rock and pop. So for me, there was just a special connection with Vice City, but also with the music. And I've uncovered that that's the same for a lot of people, I think, you know. And there seems to be a stronger connection with Vice City for some reason. And it's actually maybe even hard to explain why, but it just felt natural to do it, you know. It just felt like the right thing. And obviously, it's a lot of work to get a band together, so I had to make sure that, okay, this is a good idea. You have to really believe it if you want to push an idea forward. So that was the only thing I truly believed in that I'd like to spend my time pursuing, and that's pretty much the sort of basis of it.
Say goodnight, Mr. Diaz.
I think it's good that, like, the 80s seem to be very popular at the moment with, like, Stranger Things and there's other ones that I'm blanking on right now, but you know, it's very popular at the moment, so I think it's the perfect time to do it as well.
Oh, we gotta redecorate this place. We gotta make it look older. I can't stand this look.
Tommy, what do you say?
What do you say we put a bar in them?
You're my lawyer, Rosenberg.
Personally, I think that, like, we're a wide variety of a band, and we're from different places across Ireland. So it meant a lot to me when we came to my hometown, I suppose. We've been to Galway, We've been up north to Belfast as well. But when everyone came down, I think it was actually the first show for me where I felt most at home and most comfortable on stage. And I had a lot of familiar faces in the crowd. And we'd worked so hard in it, and we'd done so much rehearsing. And I think always the first one or two gigs, when it comes to it, is it takes some time to get your feet grounded. And it was the first gig for me where I felt everyone had a good time on stage. There was nervous energy, but in a good way. And it just went really smooth. And it was our first big sold out show, I suppose. It was the first big venue we did, over 500 tickets. And I walked out of there with a big proud head and tall shoulders, I suppose. And luckily for once, I didn't have to drive home after it. So I did go out and, I went out and celebrated, I suppose. And poor Stephen drove back to Dublin, and I got a message at 5 o'clock in the morning when I was done with my celebrating in my bed. So I think that was a really important one. But moving forward, I think we've hit probably the major cities now in Ireland, and we can't wait to do it again in the following year. But what I'm most excited about is going across the pond. So we plan on doing a lot more next year and going to other countries, but we're going to go to the UK, and we have that announced for September for Manchester and Liverpool. And this show is the last show before then, so I think we have to give it so much energy tonight, and because it's a celebration of absolutely fantastic. And this, as we said, this was only an idea to test markets this year, and it absolutely blew up, so can't wait to see how that goes.
Just going back to the what was the best part, I think seeing people's kind of basically how people show up. Some people show up in like full-on purple suits, and other people, there was a guy with like a cutout AK-47 or something. Yeah. Like they're real, like, committed to the game, and it's not just, oh, we'll go to this gig. It's like, we're going to celebrate Vice City as well, so it's pretty cool.
When we played in Belfast, before the show went on, I went out to get Red Bull, and I came back, and I said there was probably 200 people lying, and we're always here, like, doing stuff like this before the show starts, and you see people all dressed up, like, excessively, wigs, glasses, like, that's another aspect. It's not just about the soundtrack in Vice City. There's a whole character to it. You do have that genre of movies like The Godfather, the style, the hairstyles, the characters. It's, you could come in a Hawaiian shirt, or you could come dressed as Al Pacino, and it would all sit perfectly. It's, some people take it as, when you go look at the crowd outside, they take it as a way of life. And as we see, as time goes on, we've got more people getting jobs in the style of being full-time gamers, you know, being social media influencers. So it might be someone that just enjoys 80 music, or this could be their whole part of life, and that's great to see as well. And there's something for everyone there.
Oh, way to go, tough guy. Beat him to a pulp. That should make him real chatty.
You want some too?
I mean, look, this is a huge production. There's 10 people actively involved in it. So there's so many areas that, like, tiny little things you don't think that you think can be a point of failure. And thankfully, we've been pretty fucking solid for the whole thing. There was that. But I mean, I think for me personally, you know, I get so into the music sometimes. And I think I was up in Belfast and too into the music. Thank you. And I decided to play this solo that I'm playing, and I'm really, really kind of in the moment, and I'm closing my eyes, and I'm like, I'm just being a poser. So I'm really, really getting into this solo. I'm just in the music, and then all of a sudden I get a smack in the face with a beach ball, courtesy of Kozak putting it into the crowd. So yeah, that was, I mean, like I said, out of all the things that could potentially go wrong, the fact that the worst thing was beyond our control, getting a fucking beach ball to the face, is pretty awesome. You know, it wasn't it. Yeah, that's, I don't know. Does anyone else have any bad moments? Oh yeah.
Well, when you said the gig started at 10 and I was casually walking through Galway.
Oh yeah, losing Jer. Losing Jer in Cork. He was having so much fun having his best moment that he almost ruined everyone else's moment by not actually showing up.
We're in the Roisin Dubh, and sometimes they say to me, they talk to me, and there's like one of those monkeys with chimes in my head. And I was like, what time are you on stage? And it was like 10. So we were staying on the other side of Air Square, so in a hostel, and I went back to have a shower and get changed. And I was like, FaceTiming the family, walking down. Yeah, it's going to be a good gig. And I'm like getting missed calls. I'm like, lads, go away. And they were like, we're at the band door ready to go on stage. And I was like, the gig's not for an hour. And he's like, we're ready to go on. Like, and I'm still, I put it in, I was a 9 minute walk away when the show should have started. Look, stop looking at me with evil eyes. Still, they're still not over it.
To paint the, like, the perfect picture of that. Yes. I have to mention this. I was parked right outside the venue after bringing in the gear, and I had to move the car over to where we were staying that night. So like 10, 15 minutes across the thing. So I drove the car over right before we were going to go on stage, and I'm running to get back to the venue as quick as I can. And I'm like halfway back running down the road, and then I see Jer driving in the car, not a care in the world, in the opposite direction. Yeah.
Well,
you didn't
say anything.
I think I called you and I said, does Jer know that we're going on stage in a minute?
And that's why we send an itinerary email prior to the event. So
I think that's Ryanair every time.
Yeah. I don't know why I call it an itinerary. Yeah. It just sounds professional. That's why I do that. But
it should be an RTFM email.
But on that note, like, because we've only started this since last October, and we've only had a handful of gigs, really. Now, granted, they've been going really well, but October was our first gig. Smashed it in Dublin. Then our next gig wasn't until February. So there was long gaps between the gigs. So there was a lot of stuff we still needed to learn, like about ourselves, even for myself, how to manage a team to make sure that we're all together. It's a lot of people here, you know? So there's always something that comes up, small things, you know, whether it's something related to the sound, something. And that was a huge improvement that we've made. Like, we have Keith now, the 10th member. We didn't have him in the first gig, but we realized pretty quickly that we needed somebody else on the team. So whenever something kind of bad happens, or something, you know, I don't want to call it bad, but something that may affect our performance, we remedy it pretty quick. So I have to say that we're doing all a great job, like, to have gotten to this level that we're at now in such a short time. So that's, and Jer is grand now. He's here with us.
Not
as you can see, he has a clause. And no more beach balls in small venues unless they're outdoor venues.
Mercedes,
you try living with it. Anyway, let me point out some of our more distinguished guests.
I will talk with Quito for sure, because everybody loves him. Like, everybody screaming, Quito, 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 and throwing balls, like beach balls on him. So, definitely Quito.
Do you want to take it, Richard?
Me?
Yeah, go
on. What would I be?
You'd be a better juror.
I wouldn't mind doing your job, yeah. No. I'll be right behind you all night, young man. No. No, fucking, I couldn't replace anyone here. I mean, I'd be Paul's guitar, maybe, or something like that. Just have him fondle me all night. I don't know.
So I can put your
knees straight. Yeah. Snap it if you want. Ooh. Daddy.
Oh, this is going around. How do I follow that? I was going to... I'm trying to think of who I'm going to pick on. I think I would be Paul, so we would come in at the right spot on Billie Jean.
This is now a collection of our worst moments. This is just a roast. Maybe we should have done this after the game.
We need, like,
That's a joke, but I get you.
I mean, this wasn't actually hard to think about. I definitely would love to have been the lead singer. You know, I always wish that I could sing, and sing as amazing as this guy. Like, huge respect to his voice. Fantastic range, great energy on stage. Just to have that freedom to kind of go into the crowd. But for me, like, vocals was always a thing, and I could never get to that stage. So I always envy lead vocals. So that would be my answer.
I think I'd like either one of the two lads on guitar, I think, because I've always kind of always wanted to get into that a bit. Yeah, but yeah, because it's kind of some stuff you do is quite impressive, you know.
I'd like your plays. When I did bass for a bit in college, and especially because it's the 80s kind of sound, there's a lot of, especially the Fever Station, a lot of really nice funky bass lines in there. Yeah, I'd like your job.
They are fun to play though.
I would be female lead vocal, I think. Yeah, exactly. I'll get all the Instagram followers.
Did you get home from Kilkenny okay?
Yeah, that would be funny. No, but honestly, like, I have quite a high vocal range, so I'm like jealous when you sing Atomic. Atomic Kids in America, and they're like banging tunes.
Have a very high voice,
than thank you.
Oh, I haven't even thought about this. I don't think I could replace anybody. I don't know. I'd probably be the newest addition, which is the cowbell. Or the chimes, but also G on keys would be my other option. I feel like sometimes I look back and G is in his own little world. He's kind of behind all of us. When I look back, he's on his own little buzz, like playing away with his air guitar and everything. So I think I would be G on keys.
I'd probably be Bren, I'd say. That, you know, bass in the 80s, like Jared said. Such a tight instrument, and it's like so important on every track that we play. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, like, I mean, guitarists are just smarter bassists, really, but yeah. It would be nice. I think it would be nice to just like be able to turn my brain off and play bass all night.
Oh, wow.
No, I'm kidding. Fucking.
What about Keith, though? Yeah, who would you want to be? Give Keith the mic.
I'd honestly like to just jump around on stage with a saxophone, all right, like Richie. That sounds like great fun.
Not a bad job.
Yeah, every single gig, it's just I see him in the background doing moves I've never seen him do every other gig. So he changes them around and just gets to dance. So that sounds great to me, because it'd be completely the opposite to me, where I'm doing a million things with 100 arms at all times. So yeah.
I like how nobody wants to be the drummer. I'll just say that.
That's a hard job, though.
Yeah, it's true. I'm really glad nobody wants to be me, because my job is secure then. So very happy to hear that.
Tomas, you have protected and served me well. And now you must leave us before we reach the open seas. I will lower my personal launch.
It has come up, and then again, and like we always joked, like, oh, we're getting sued by Rockstar, but they don't own the rights to that music either, so keeping it open.
Don't poke the bear.
That's not what we planned you to say.
That's a challenge.
Can't go off script if there is no script. No. And like we were saying, like that's a really nice question as well, because like I have met, like I think we all have at some point met some voice actors, people who work in that industry. They're really enthusiastic. They're amazing at their job. They're passionate people. They don't get the recognition they deserve, but like I've seen them at conventions and stuff, and seen them giving interviews, and like they'd be a bit of crack, and it would be nice to reach out to. What was the guy you were saying is the guy who plays Trevor? Yeah,
yeah, you can't remember his name.
Yeah, our first choice would have been Ray Liotta, but you know,
I think it's late for that. Yeah, it'd be great if, like, since there was Love Fest. We've got a song in a set, which is a band that was purely invented for Vice City. If Rockstar are watching and you need a new animated band for your next game, we would love to take part to be the new type of Love Fist. We would make the music for it, and yeah.
Love Foot.
Love Fist Revival.
And the question does... Oh, that definitely caught me off guard there.
Lads, the energy's getting really nailed here.
I think.
Oh. Jesus Christ!
Oh, set him up and knock him down, lads.
But on a serious note, like that question does come up quite a bit, and
for me, it's interesting because I never thought about that. Like, that was something that people have asked me, and I haven't really had a good think about it to be able to answer it. But I think I might know the reason is because I want to see how far we can go on our own accord without depending on, like, a partner or depending on sponsorship or anything like that. I want to see how much we in ourselves, with our own energy, with our own work, can go without leaning or relying on somebody else or a company, for example. As well, once you reach out to a big business or a big corporation, they're you know, we don't know how they will take it either. So for me, I'd rather keep going as much as we can with our own energy, with our own mission, with our own vision, because these things can get muddled sometimes when you bring other entities in. So for me, that's definitely not something that really right now I think is necessary. If it does, if we get approached, or I'd be happy to have a conversation, but it's not something that I feel like is something we need to look at right now. But it's a great question to ask. It does come up pretty often as well.
Yo, Ken, looking for movie talent. You interested?
Sure, but you'd have to talk to my agent.
Huge. Well, like, to be honest, we didn't know how big it was going to get. We didn't know how people would respond. You know, we're only in our, what, seventh gig, maybe, is it? Just like, there's still so much that we can do, and we're taking it step by step. We've definitely added more gigs to the list this year, and we've done more gigs than expected. We obviously have to pace ourselves because we don't want to jump too fast, and I think we did kind of speed up and accelerated a bit, and I think it was just the right amount. We are planning the UK, as Jer was saying, so that'll be our next leap to see how the UK take us and how we sell tickets there as well. Like, for us, it's a lot of work to push a gig. It's a lot of gig to sell. It's a lot of work to sell and market every gig.
It's a lot of gig to sell as well.
It's a lot of gig to sell. And it's a lot of hard work, so we don't want to burn out too quick as well. So I would say we take it at one step at a time. We might take two steps. And if it happens that we get a big opportunity, for example, to play a festival or a big venue, we will definitely consider taking it.
Vice City
in Miami definitely will be amazing. So yeah, that we could say that could be one of the targets, but definitely want to continue to grow at a good pace. And you know, when the acceleration happens and we see an opportunity, we're definitely going to leap on it.
Son, I can shoot a fly off your head at 80 feet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I learned it in the army.
Yeah.
Yeah? Hey, yes. Alien especially. Yeah. I've been gaming for a long, long time. During COVID, I was playing a lot of Apex Legends, which I thought was really fun. I was playing with this guy. Played a bit of Warzone. Did we play together as well? Oh shit, sorry, okay, sorry. My bad. Like, I love all so many different genres. Like, I like anything from first-person shooters to fucking city builders. You know, I'm big into, like, the Anno series, which probably nobody knows. It's like a German game. Big into that. City Skylines. I love all these, like, organization games. Probably that's because I'm organizing. I'm into that stuff, so love building stuff and planning cities and all that. I'm big into that, but I do like to just let go and play a bit of Warzone or Apex as well from time to time.
I've been gaming since I was very, very young, and right now, since I was a wee babby, I've got very fond memories of waking up on a Saturday morning, turning on my PlayStation 2, and popping on Jack and Daxter, Jack 2, Crash Bandicoot. Man, Jack and Daxter, we need a Jack 4, like, because Jack X wasn't proper. You know, Sly Raccoon, fucking Metal Gear Solid 3. And we've got Metal Gear Solid Delta coming out as well, which I'm so excited for. Mortal Kombat, man, like, I wasted my childhood. But now I absolutely, I know, I love it. I honestly loved it. But I gotta say, I have the fondest memories of playing Spider-Man 2 on PS2. Yeah, yeah. And Spider-Man. Exactly. And now we got the Spider-Man PS5. That number 2 is coming out with Miles Morales and Peter Parker, and I can't wait to play that. I need to buy a PS5, but I'm really looking forward to that as well. So yeah, lots of games.
I gotta say, best two games: Mario Kart Double Dash on the GameCube and Star Wars Battlefront 2, 2005. Oh, yes. They're awesome. The untouchable, yeah. The 2005 one.
That narrated campaign with
Tamara
Morrison.
Oh my god, it's so good, yeah. And all the mods are so good.
Score one for the Republic.
Yeah, for me, I think Guitar Hero was my childhood, playing Guitar Hero 3. I mean, I play keys, yeah. But it was. But actually, I used to play on controller, and also was. It's hard. I think that the guitar is harder. Yeah, but definitely Guitar Hero. Have my heart.
Turn it into a MIDI controller.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I like all the free roaming story missions, so I definitely like the Saints Row's, obviously the GTA's. I like the Just Causes too, but first person shooters are at heart, and I really liked Black Ops 2 Zombies. Really liked Black Ops. I could have spent days playing it, and obviously we all had the COVID war zone with the boys, nights or whatever. But yeah, I'm really looking. I think as well with the new GTA coming out and they're basing it off the same map as Vice City, I think it's going to make this shine a lot more as well. I think you can't beat the original, I suppose. Anyone else for favourite games?
Yeah, I think probably my earliest memories are probably Castle Wolfenstein on my dad's computer. He got a computer from work, and I think me and my sister were playing games we shouldn't have been playing at that time when we were like 6 and 7 years old. But and then, you know, I got a PlayStation later. I played games like Abe's Odyssey, and that's probably still one of my favorite games, even though nobody really remembers that one.
Of course you'd love that, because it's impossible.
Yeah.
Follow me.
Yeah, and then, these days I mostly play PC games, and I got big into like shooters like TF2 and Overwatch and those kind of online shooters. And but also the new Zelda game.
Who's your Overwatch main friend?
I used to play a lot of Tracer, but now I play Ana, who's the sniper. I kind of like that.
Speaking of being so young, my sister got Liberty City on PlayStation 2, and I was so young, I was playing it, and I asked her, how do you get in the car? I didn't know what a triangle was, so she taught me. She said, you get into the car pressing the witch's hat.
You know, Ken, I think this could be the beginning of a beautiful business relationship.
Donkey Kong Country.
I trusted you, Tommy. I would have had you made.
Very, very excited. Yeah, Paul definitely.
PS5 for it. Yeah, that's it, guys. All right, guys, that's it for the art campaign. We are here, Grand Theft Audio here in Dolan's down in Limerick. It's showtime, guys. Let's rock and roll.
Yo, what is crackle? It is the Arcane Pain here. That was my interview with GTA Audio, Grand Theft Audio, coming to hopefully a city near you soon. I'm going to leave you guys with a little bit of one of their songs. Honestly, this band is amazing. Definitely check them out. They're going to be playing in Dublin in August, and then they'll be heading over across the pond to the UK, and then they'll be back over to do more shows in Ireland. So make sure you guys check them out. And this is the Arcane Pain. Thanks for watching.
Ladies, sing along, let's go!